Elisa, the Scrappy Wife behind scrappywife.com, and today I have a traveler's notebook process video for you. I am working through my deconstructed traveler's notebook for the summer of 2021, and since summer is wrapping up, then I'm going to try to be finishing this one up. So today I have a couple of pictures of the kiddos and I having some popsicles, because what's a summer more than popsicles? So I have that. I have some of the paper person collection from July, so I feel like I'll probably use some of that, and then just some solid papers over here. It should be pretty simple. That is what I love about traveler's notebook layouts, is that they're simple and quick. So I will put you guys on fast forward. I will link everything that I end up using down below. Otherwise, let's go. Okay, I started out by picking out a couple of papers and trimming them down to 4 1/4 by 8 1/4 for traveler's notebook size. I loved the one with all of the pink lines that looked like confetti, and then it really complemented this pink notebook paper look really nicely. So I have my two pieces right here. I definitely want to use this particular card that has all of the ice cream and it says The Sweet Life. And then I like the card on top of it. I think I'm gonna go with pinks and purples and blues for this particular layout. If you're wondering, I don't normally try to match my layouts to the colors that are in my pictures. To me, that kind of limits the creativity personally, and so I just go with the colors that are in the pictures. They are real life, and then I pick supplies that kind of make me happy, bring me joy, and if they match, that's awesome. If they don't, that's okay too. The only time I really worry about it is when there is like a huge clash, like a super bright orange picture or something like that. All right, I'm trying to pick out some solid colors. I don't have a ton of solid color scrapbook paper. These are from the Hip Kit Club, and so I think the orange is kind of nice actually, because it does actually match the orange in several of those popsicles. So I'll use that to mat my pictures. I do like to mat my pictures because I think it makes them pop just a little bit more, and it's another fun way to bring in color. So I'll be matting them. This one I'm going to mat actually on the light pink, and then I'll end up matting the one with my boys and their popsicles on the orange paper. So again, another fun way to bring in little pops of color, some dimension, which I love working with because I'm in this deconstructed traveler's notebook and it's on binder ring, so I can use as much dimension as I want to. So trimming out these, and then I actually end up deciding to go ahead and mat this ice cream card just because it gets a little bit lost on the white notebook looking paper over on the side. So I'll do that and mat it on some pink paper as well. That actually matches really nicely. So trimming that out. And those are the biggest elements. When I'm working on a traveler's notebook spread, I always start with the biggest elements first, and then kind of get smaller and smaller, just because there's not a lot of space to work with. So you don't have a lot of room to like play around or a lot of wasted space. You really have to kind of get to the point in a traveler's notebook, which is again one of the reasons I like it, because it's going to tell a quick story. It's going to be pretty. It's not going to be overwhelming to create a layout. It's not something that's going to take me an hour. So I really, really do like that. Okay, I'm wanting to use some different stamps. So I have the stamps that came with this July release. I also have some puffy stickers. I am not the best stamper. I've gotten so much better, but I generally like to stamp on a separate piece of paper and then trim out that stamp and then put it on my paper, just because I don't have the confidence that I'm going to do it right. So I stamped this multiple times, just trying to get the very best inking up that I can. I don't feel like this is wasting paper. It's really just good practice for me. So I like the final one. So I'll peel off that stamp. And then I also want to do, there's a stamp that has the heat wave, like it has the weather information. So the reason we're eating popsicles in this particular picture is A, summer, because popsicles are necessary. And it has been so hot in Northern Virginia, and the humidity has been crazy, and my kids, it was so hard to get them to play outside. So I actually was able to convince them to go outside, and I went outside with them and we played, but we only lasted like 20 minutes because it was so hot and I had to promise them popsicles just to apologize for the heat. It was so hot, but they were troopers. We played soccer and rode bikes and it was fun. We got out a little bit of energy, but it's just silly hot. So you just can't stay outside very long. Okay, trimming out some of my stamping here, and I actually decided, so I stamped these on colored paper. I don't really like how it turned out. It just, it was too much color, which is shocking, I know. I'm usually all about the color. So here's my little weather information, and I decided, you know what, I'm gonna stamp this again, but on white paper, and I can layer it on top of the piece I already stamped and have a little bit of color, but more white, so it's easier to read. So I'll just trim this one out, and instead of going on the outer box, I will focus on the inner box. So when I layer it onto the piece I've already trimmed out, there's like a little orange border, which I think is nice. It's a nice little detail, and details are really important in a traveler's notebook spread. So layering that, and then I decide I truthfully want a little bit more white in my other stamp piece. So it says summer snapshots, and I end up deciding I'll just mat it on white, and it'll bring a little bit of brightness to it and a little bit more attention to it. So I'll just grab some of this scrap paper and again trim out just a tiny little border, and it's just enough to really brighten up that whole look. At this point, I'm pretty happy with how the left side of the spread is coming together, and I'll take my attention over to the right side. So I want to do a combination of stamping and stickers. So there is a stamp that says feels like summer, and I think that is perfect to describe the weather. And then I love these stickers that say sunshine. So I will combine those. I'm going to do feels like summer up at the top, and I'm going to be super brave and stamp directly on the page. I was nervous, but it did work out. So it feels like summer right there in the middle. Ta-da! See, I'm getting better at stamping. So put that in the middle, and then I want to use the word sunshine right underneath it. But I'm afraid if I take the stickers off one by one, all the spacing and lining up will get messed up. So I just roll back the clear plastic until the top half of each sticker is kind of exposed, stick that down, and then just roll it off the sheet. So that's a great little tip for keeping your stickers lined up, especially when they're individual letters like this and you want the spacing that you see. The cool thing about it is if I had wanted to squish this in or spread it out, I could have done that as well. But I wanted it exactly like I saw on the plastic sheet. I was wanting to add a few more stickers to the side, but I wanted to go ahead and punch my holes first so that I would be able to see where they would be, because I like these little like splash looking stickers. And so I wanted to add them as like a splash up from the ice cream and bring in just a touch of blue over on this side of the spread to kind of mirror the blue that is on the left side. And I think it turned out super cute. So now I'll just adhere things down, and you can see, so I've done all the big pieces. Now I'm kind of working towards the smaller pieces. I had my big pieces chosen. Then I started doing some of the stamping and the titles, which were medium pieces. I'll get everything adhered, and then I will go back with the smallest pieces. So you kind of work from big to small when planning your layout, just to make sure everything is included and balanced. And it's also a good reminder for yourself to include those details. If you are thinking in your head, these are my big elements, these are my medium elements, these are my small elements, then you'll remember to go back and do those small elements, those tiny little details. To make my stamping pop even more, I'm going to grab some washi tape. This is just grid washi tape. I think I got this particular roll from Target. They sell it at Felicity Jane. They sell it on Amazon, just plain grid washi. And I'll pull that over from the side. And it, again, just brings a little bit more attention to those stamped pieces. And then I decide I also want to include it on the right side of the spread because I like bringing the two together. So I'll take little bits and put them underneath this ice cream card just to kind of add a little bit of extra interest. Again, the details in a traveler's notebook spread are important. Just focus on those small little things, and it really is what makes the spread special, what makes it kind of stick out. Once that is done, all I'm going to do is add a few puffy hearts over on the left side and do a bit of journaling, and this traveler's notebook entry will be complete. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider hitting that subscribe button as well as the bell notification button. I have linked all of the supplies that I could find down below in the description box. Heads up, some of those are affiliate links. It doesn't cost you any more, but it does go a long way to supporting this channel. And speaking of supporting this channel, thank you so much to my scrappy YouTube members. Thank you so much for your monthly support. If you are interested in finding out more about Scrappy YouTube membership, then make sure to click the join button, or there is a link in the description box below that you can check out. All right, I hope that you have a fabulous day, and as always, keep it creative.